Hello everyone. Today I'll be showcasing how to use AWS Certificate Manager Private CA, or ACM Private CA, to issue certificates to Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, or EKS, workloads using the cert-manager plugin. First, I'll provide an overview of the cert-manager plugin and the integration between ACM Private CA and EKS. Then we'll look at a brief demo of how this integration works in practice. The Private CA Kubernetes Cert Manager plugin is an open source plugin for Cert Manager that offers a secure certificate authority solution for Kubernetes containers. ACM Private CA is AWS's fully managed and highly available Private CA service, and Cert Manager is a widely adopted solution for TLS certificate management in Kubernetes. Customers who use Cert Manager for certificate lifecycle management can use this plugin with ACM Private CA to improve security over the default Cert Manager CA, which stores keys in plain text in server memory. Kubernetes containers and applications use digital certificates to provide secure authentication and encryption over TLS. With this plugin, Cert Manager requests TLS certificates from ACM Private CA, a highly available and auditable managed CA that secures CA keys using FIPS validated hardware security modules, or HSMs. Together, Cert Manager and the plugin for ACM Private CA provide certificate automation for TLS in a range of configurations, including at the ingress, on the pod, and mutual TLS between pods. You can use the ACM Private CA Kubernetes Cert Manager plugin with Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, a self-managed Kubernetes on AWS and Kubernetes on-premise. If you take a look at this diagram, you can see there are four different ways to terminate TLS for applications running on an EKS cluster: on the load balancer, on the ingress controller, and directly on the pod. The fourth way is to use mutual TLS, or MTLS, between pods. In this demo, I'll show you how to issue a certificate to terminate TLS on the ingress controller. You can follow along with the steps in this demo, as well as dive deeper into other TLS termination options in the publicly available ACM Private CA workshop. I put the link to this workshop in the description of this video. Be aware that if you run the workshop in your own account, you will of course incur charges for the services you consume. Now let's take a brief look at how this works. Now that we're in the AWS console, let's first take a look at the resources I've pre-configured for this demo. I'll navigate to the ACM Private CA console, where we can see the root and subordinate CAs I've created. We'll be using this subordinate CA to issue certificates to our EKS cluster. Now, if we look at the EKS console, we can see the Kubernetes cluster, PCA EKS demo, that has been pre-created in this account. It has two worker nodes in a node group named PCA EKS demo workers. Next, I'll switch to the CLI and use a command to install the cert manager add-on to Kubernetes. This add-on will allow us to automate the management and issuance of TLS certificates. Now we need to install the AWS PCA Issuer plugin, which is an add-on to Cert Manager. First, to do this, we need to create an OpenID Connect provider for our cluster. Now we'll use EKS CTL to create an IAM service account that the PCA Issuer plugin will use. I'll clear the screen to make it a little more readable. And then we'll use Helm to install the AWS PCA Issuer. Notice that this command also sets the service account as the one we created in the previous step. Now I'll run the getPods command for the namespace AWS PCA Issuer. And as you can see, we now have a pod in the ready state running in the AWS PCA Issuer namespace. Now we will use the AWS PCA Issuer plugin to create a cluster issuer, which will be used with the ACM Private CA to issue certificates. As you can see in the deployment file, we're naming the ARN of the subordinate CA that I showed earlier in the demo. I'll use the kubectl apply command to go ahead and deploy this YAML file. Okay, now we've set up our EKS cluster and prepared it to start requesting certificates. We need to create an ingress controller. I'll use the following command to install nginx ingress. Nginx ingress is built around the Kubernetes ingress resource using a config map to store the Nginx configuration. This command also deploys a network load balancer. I'll navigate to the EC2 console so we can take a look at this load balancer that was created. It's currently in the provisioning state, but after a few minutes it should switch to active. We need to copy the DNS name of this load balancer as it will be used in our certificate request. Before we request our certificate, we'll create a new namespace that will contain our application and the secret or certificate that we create. Next, I'll create a new file called eks-cert.yaml, where we'll place the information for our certificate request. Here you can see I'm placing the DNS name of that load balancer in under the DNS name section of the certificate request. We're also naming this eks-cert, and it uses the namespace we just created in the previous command. I'll save this file and exit. Now we can use the same apply command we've used before to go ahead and request this new certificate. Let's use the get certificate command to check the status of our certificate. It should show ready. We can also use the describe certificate command to see more details about this certificate we requested. You may notice a few things in the result of this command. We can see the DNS name of the load balancer that we put in the certificate request, as well as the EKS example domain common name used again in that certificate request from earlier. We can also see that the certificate status is ready, and it is up to date and has not expired. You'll also notice that the key algorithm is RSA and the key length is 2048. We specified all this in our certificate request as part of that eks-cert.yaml file. Now we simply need to deploy a demo application and expose this application using our ingress controller. This will create a basic service that we can expose via our ingress controller. I'll create a new file named helloworld.yaml. Now I'll again use kubectl apply to deploy this new service. So far we've issued our certificate and we've deployed the demo application. Now we just need to expose this new application using a Kubernetes ingress resource. We'll create a new file called example-ingress.yaml and add the following content. We'll add our load balancer's DNS name under the TLS host and rules host field. Now we just need to save this file and go ahead and apply this resource as well. Okay, our ingress controller has been created, and it now has a certificate issued to it to secure the communications with TLS. And that's it. We've issued a certificate to our EKS cluster that will be used to secure communications to our applications using TLS, with TLS terminating at our ingress controller. Thanks for your time, and make sure to consult the ACM Private CA documentation for more information on issuing certificates for Kubernetes workloads.